Hey guys, welcome to Boxing Squared for boxing news and views from around the internet. Well, it took a few days, but Mark Breland has broken his silence in response to claims by Deontay Wilder that he spiked his water in the rematch with Tyson Fury. He's also referred to Mark Breland, who threw in the towel, which ended the fight against Tyson Fury on February the 22nd, referred to him as disloyal. And Mark Breland, of course, is no longer working with Deontay Wilder. That separation was confirmed recently. And not surprising given some of the things that have been said and been going on, but some of these claims by Wilder himself, no actual evidence to back it up. If he does have some proof that his water was spiked, which he believes that Breland was responsible for, then he needs to actually come forward and provide it. But Breland on a social media has made a relatively long post, and accompanying it, and you can see here on screen, Teddy Atlas, and so this was from Teddy Atlas's podcast, The Fight, more specifically talking about the glove situation, but covering the whole sort of saga in general. And Breland said like only he can. Anyone who really knows me knows I wouldn't go back and forth unless it's in the ring. I've been boxing since I was 8 years old, so I didn't give a big portion of my life to the sport. I dedicated my entire life to the sport. But I have never seen things I'm seeing now in all those years. I'm only on social media because of my girl. We went somewhere and there was a picture of me and we were very surprised. And she said, this is one of the reasons you need social media in this day and time. She said, there are people who have deep admiration for you and social media is a way to give them access to you. She asked me all the time, and I'm tired of it, do I want to go back to life without it? I always say no, because the amount of support, love, and gratitude I get lets me know all the hard work I put into my career was worth it. I looked at and read thousands of video texts and comments, and I would put 1,000 of them if I could, because so many of them were 100, and then he's got a flex emoji, but I can't. But I do have a file for all of them that move me. I thank all of you for your words. I chose this one because it hit most of the marks and said only like he could. Thanks, Teddy Atlas. Let me add this last. The Twitter pic that's out there is not from me. It's not how I speak, and there's nothing funny about this show and that's going on. Stay tuned, stay well, and I'm still standing. The flex emoji again at Teddy Atlas. So Mark Breland, who has certainly been in the spotlight in the past week or so, again, proving what a classy guy he is. He is the one out of the two, him and Deontay Wilder, that is actually acting like a champion. I mean, I think many people forget Mark Breland was an elite boxer, an elite fighter, a world champion, and he's acting like one here. Unlike Deontay Wilder, who's thrown him completely under the bus, throwing out claims that he doesn't have any evidence to substantiate around Mark Breland allegedly spiking his water, because that's somehow a conclusion Deontay Wilder or whoever's in his ear has been feeding him. And I would note that, Deontay Wilder talks about the gloves being loaded and all that sort of stuff, accuses Tyson Fury of cheating. And I noted this in a Patreon video. If, given Deontay Wilder thinks there was some sort of egg-sized weight in Tyson Fury's gloves, shouldn't he be thanking Deontay Wilder for saving him from further punishment? Because Wilder is saying the gloves were loaded. So Breland, who was the only one in that corner who seemed to care about Wilder, the condition that he was in, which, if it was true, which, let's face it, it's not, because it's ridiculous for all the reasons Teddy Atlas has outlined. He should actually be thanking Mark Breland rather than sort of going on about him, all that sort of stuff. I mean, I just think the whole thing is farcical. Deontay Wilder is in a race to the bottom at the moment, losing credibility every time he opens his mouth. But Mark Breland here, with the way that he is speaking and acting, he's getting the message across. Basically what Teddy Atlas is saying for him. as opposed to having to, really respond and say something negative and nasty. It was a classy response, and I think Mark Breland has been treated very unfairly here by Deontay Wilder. Remember, Breland was with him for more than a decade, pretty much from the beginning of his pro career, but all of that out the window. And now we're getting these myriad of claims building on stuff, after the fight, it was the costume. A couple of days after the fight, it was apparently the costume that led to the loss. His legs were weakened. And then a couple of months later, he said he felt like a zombie, wasn't right, all that sort of stuff. But now he's targeting some spiked water that he believes Mark Breland must have given him. But no evidence to back any of that up. I mean, it really is a sad situation. And it's a sad way for a former heavyweight champion to be acting in public. And for those who think it's building the fight, it's not. And this is not some sort of tactic here to build a third fight. This is just way off the deep end stuff that has gone beyond the ridiculous. And I know that there is a small cabal of hardcore and demented fans that are just lapping this up and believing everything that is coming out of Deontay Wilder's mouth. But in terms of Mark Breland, I think he's shown again, he's a classy guy. The only one in that corner that cared about Wilder. And he's the one bearing the brunt of Deontay Wilder's wrath, apart from Tyson Fury, and unjustifiably so in my view. But what do you make of it all? Drop a comment, loud and often, hit like, hit subscribe, follow me on Twitter, boxing_squared. I'm out.